Koko, the signing gorilla, is the voice of nature and an ambassador for all endangered species. Our On the Move host, Donna Yeager, visits with Lisa Holliday, who tells us of her work with Koko and the latest developments at the Gorilla Foundation. Now, here's Lisa and Donna.
Hi, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move, and I'd like to welcome our very special guest, Lisa Holliday.
Hello.
Welcome, Lisa. Now, I have been following Koko for many, many years, and she is the love of all of our lives. She's so amazing. What is your official title there?
I'm the executive personal assistant to Dr. Francine Patterson, otherwise known as Penny.
Cool.
Yeah.
Very good. And how many years have you been there?
3 years.
Cool. Very
good. Yeah.
Well, I remember back in the 70s, I saw her in a couple of different news little pieces, and then she was there on the cover of National Geographic.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's really when a lot more people really saw her for the first time.
That's when she really became famous.
Yeah. That's great.
Yeah.
And she was holding a camera, mm-hmm. taking a picture. Does she really like doing that?
Yes. That the picture she actually, on the cover, she actually took of herself.
Oh, wow.
That was what was so unique about it.
Oh, my gosh. That's so cool.
Yeah. Pretty much anything you see, anything we do, she can do. Really.
Yeah, really. Yeah. Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
And then I have another beautiful photograph of you with Koko, the life-size gorilla yes. stuffed animal
yes.
that you have in your office.
And we have a couple of them, yes.
And that is so neat. And yeah. that's really the size that she is, right?
Mm-hmm. That's her actual size.
Wow. Yeah.
Life-size replica. People yeah. get fooled when they walk in. They think it's her.
But yeah, exactly.
It's really good.
I did too.
Yeah.
I was surprised at Koko.
Yeah. Yeah.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
And, you know, I have been in tears several times watching documentaries about Koko mm-hmm. and the love that Penny has for Koko. It's yeah. amazing. Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
And that's the next photo that we have of Penny and Koko together. Mm-hmm. And I guess, how old was Koko when they took that photo, 40 or 41? It's pretty recent.
Oh, that's pretty recent. Yeah, I'd say probably 40 or 41. Yeah, their relationship is very unique and special, and I feel so privileged to get to watch it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. And she's so gentle.
Yes.
That's what's
gentle.
Amazing.
Mm-hmm. She's really a sweetheart and a character.
Yeah, well, like in the documentary, it shows oh my gosh, just how gentle she is. And the, you know, there's a picture that we'll show a little bit later on again mm-hmm. of her holding a flower.
Yeah.
And it's so tender with the, mm-hmm. with Penny and Koko, you know, smelling the beautiful flower. Mm-hmm. And you told me a funny story afterwards, though.
Yeah. Well, she likes to eat them. Yeah. So we had someone brand new come to visit her, and he brought her a flower arrangement, and she kept telling him to come closer and come closer. And then he handed her the flower arrangement, and she ate it in one bite. He was like, I didn't know she was going to eat it. Her favorite flowers are roses. And
oh, that's funny.
Yeah,
oh
my she enjoys God. Them.
And then we have a picture of Koko with me. I'm with Koko,
yeah.
The life-size gorilla, and that's a lot of fun to
yes.
to see. Oh, there we are. It's so cute.
Yeah, with her.
She's adorable.
With her tiger cat. Yeah, yeah. On her lap.
Oh, the kitty cat. Yeah, tiger. Mm-hmm. That was her second kitty cat, yeah. Right?
I'm not sure of the sequence. I always forget.
I know.
I know she has two now.
Right. Yeah. So. Exactly. No, but Ball is the first one.
Ball was
right,
the first one, yes.
Yeah, yeah, very
the
sweet.
One on the second National Geographic cover.
Right, exactly, yeah. Her holding Ball, cuddling Ball.
Yes.
So cute. Oh, my God. And then now we have a photo of Penny when she was younger, mm-hmm. Relating and doing sign language with Koko.
Yeah.
Went, look at how tiny she was. She's just a little thing.
I can't.
She was so cute.
I know. Just a little precious one.
Oh, yes. Such an angel. Oh,
yeah.
My gosh. Oh.
Yeah, that was the beginning.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, really, it's been really neat to watch the news. And they literally have, kind of chronologically followed her whole life.
Yes. Ron still goes in with her every day to take pictures. There is the amount of footage we have of Coco's life is pretty incredible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it really is thanks to Ron that all of that footage was done.
Yep.
And I mean, really, every mm-hmm. amazing thing that she's done, really.
Yeah. They go in every day like a family, and that's when he gets those photos.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That is great.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Oh, my gosh. And I met Ron back in the 70s, mm-hmm. and he asked me to do a scratch board of Koko. And I got a little stipend for it because mm-hmm. I just fell in love with Koko then. And so he gave me a photograph of him with Koko, mm-hmm. and I presented it to them. And they were very happy with it. And I think it's probably been in their office, for many, many, mm-hmm. many years, or maybe even at Coco's place.
It might be, yeah.
She has a house. It's really cool.
Yeah, she does.
In the documentary, I saw the neat little house with her kitchen and mm-hmm. bedroom and the blankets all over.
Yes, she builds a nest out of blankets.
Looks very comfy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'd sleep there.
I know. She does a really good job on it. She takes a lot of time and effort to make it just right.
That's cool.
Yeah. Her cats like it too.
Yeah. Well, Koko and I love art, so mm-hmm. I like to do scratch boards, and she likes to paint. So
right.
She does some beautiful pieces of artwork. I love them. They are gorgeous. And you had them all over the office walls. And they're beautiful. I would definitely buy one.
Yeah. Yeah, they are pretty great.
In my living room. Yeah.
Yeah, her brother Michael, he was a really nice, good artist as well.
Yeah.
I mean, they both are very creative. He's passed away, but his art remains.
That's
and
right.
It's still wonderful to look at.
Everyone still appreciates the beautiful artwork of Michael. Oh, that's mm-hmm. great. And I mean, it's pretty amazing when you think about it that she's able to pick the colors mm-hmm. that she wants, and wow.
Yeah.
So, and then we're going to talk about the kitten, and Koko holding the kitten.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, like you said, that is Ball, the little gray one. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's all Ball.
And which one is the National Geographic photo?
That's all Ball.
That's
yeah.
it. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's beautiful. Wow.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, just the love and the. The tenderness of, she really adored Ball.
She's really a mother to the cats. Yeah. I mean, she mm-hmm. is very protective, just like a mother would be.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she really cares for them. It's,
they're her
it
babies.
Is wonderful to, it's deep. Yeah.
It's awesome, mm-hmm. it's great.
She's really, really, really gentle with them.
Yeah, definitely. And you were very kind to invite us to your office, and we had a really wonderful chance to visit with you and learn more about the amazing stories of I knew Koko was intelligent, but my gosh, just the stories that you said. I wish we could tell all of them in 1.5 hour. I want you to come back because it's amazing, all the wonderful, loving stories that you told me. Mm-hmm. And we're going to go to the next picture where not only, you know, we spread out a lot of the wonderful photos for us at your office, but also, here we go. They're wonderful. And I think you showed us one of is that Michael or is that Ndume?
I believe I showed you a picture of Ndume.
Oh, okay, yeah.
But I showed you a picture of Michael at some
Michael
point, too.
Michael, too, right?
Yeah, yeah. They're both quite handsome fellows.
Very handsome.
Yes.
Big boys.
Yes. Yes.
Not to be confused with Michael McConaughey. She calls him a hot boy.
Hot boy, yes.
Hot boy. Oh, wow. She's pretty amazing. I'm going to start blushing. I'm just popping down.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. We agree on that, too.
Yep, we'll get to that, yeah.
Okay. But I like how she reads her mail.
Yes.
Her fan mail. That picture is amazing.
Yes. She really likes to look through magazines and find things. And then you bring in her fan mail. She loves to look at the pictures and have you read it to her. Or she looks at it herself.
Yeah.
She loves compliments and doting. So she's very...
The concentration on her face.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
She's really into it. Yeah.
And you can kind of see the kitchen in the background there, too.
Yep.
Really, it looks just like a regular kitchen.
Yeah, it is. It has all of the appliances
cabinets.
You could use. Yeah.
Wow.
It's only missing a real oven. It has a microwave, though.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Incredible.
Yeah.
And then the next photograph we're going to see, Ndume.
Yes.
And like I said, he is majestic.
He is.
He's a big boy.
He is a big, sweet boy.
Oh, my gosh. Mm-hmm. Look at the six-pack on his tummy.
Yeah, now that, he's sitting on a pink flower pillow that he got for Easter that he absolutely adores and takes it with him everywhere.
Really?
You can just see the edges of that pink pillow in that picture, but we had a series of them because he really, everywhere he went, that pink pillow went.
Wow. Cool.
Yeah.
Smart boy.
Yes.
Right. He's looking for the comforts in life.
Yes. Well, they both like to sit on comfortable things.
Oh,
he likes to sit on small things, typically.
Oh,
little
really?
Stools, you know, or in little, you know, bowls.
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
little,
like the Tupperware.
Like
yeah, the bucket things. He likes to sit in those. Yeah. Tucks himself in nicely.
And they're considerably smaller than him.
Yeah, he's a big fellow. I don't quite understand the need to get in these very small things. But maybe it's, you know, comfortable and safe and
comforting,
warm,
yeah.
Maybe.
Think, yeah. Oh,
yeah.
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 Well, he's amazing. Oh, my gosh.
Neither one of them want to be too hot or too cold at any given time, so.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's what you said about the air conditioning.
Yeah, they have air conditioning
she
and
likes
heat.
Her air conditioning.
Yeah, if it's too hot, she says, forget about it. I'll stay inside where
I'm
it's
not
cool.
Going out.
And he's the same way. Yeah. So they're very pampered.
That's funny. And then I like the other photograph where Koko is playing the recorder. It looks like a frontward flute, but it's a recorder. And wow, that's amazing.
She's really into instruments.
Is she?
She's played the piano recently. She played the bass with Flea from Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Oh, yeah.
She seems to have a natural knack for them. Really seems to enjoy them a lot. Yeah.
But I mean, she knows exactly, like how to strum the guitar, and she's great.
And, you know, if we often sing to her, and she will try to sing along. It's really sweet.
Oh, how cute!
Yeah, she's a musical girl.
Oh my God, that's great.
Yeah.
And we're gonna show the birthday candles in a minute, but she's very good at that. She likes to blow out the candles.
Yes, she does. You know, they weren't sure that that gorillas had the ability to blow or, know, she can fake sneeze, fake cough, blow out candles.
Wow.
When you first if you were to first meet her, she would ask you to blow on her by doing it for you first and asking you to, you know, do it back.
Yeah.
To get a sense of what you've been eating or who you are, your smell kind
cool.
of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
So she kind of sums you up and
she kind of
assesses
you up.
The
yeah.
situation.
Yeah.
Are you okay?
I keep hoping every time she does it to me that I've eaten something really amazing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Like lasagna. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm hungry. Anyway. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Well, and also, we talked about Matthew a moment ago.
Yes.
But she's had a lot of other visitors as well. But,
she has.
But
yes.
She, I love in the documentary, you said you're telling Penny how Coco's morning went.
Yes.
You know, and she reads recipes.
Yes.
She actually picks out what food she wants for that day.
Yes. We bring her magazines, and sometimes members will donate yeah. subscriptions to like healthy eating, you know, and she will go through them and yeah. pick out recipes she'd like you to try. And one day, well, she was watching, what Penny had let me know later is she yeah. had been watching the cooking channel and saw them make a grilled cheese sandwich.
Oh,
she found
gosh.
A recipe in her cookbook. I do a lot of Coco's meals.
Right, right. And
preparation. Yeah. And she saw me walking up the driveway and they said, she's been carrying this recipe around all day waiting
wow.
for you. So I come over and she hands it to me and basically says, hurry up and get this. Cook, you know, make this. So my job is to figure out how to do it within her dietary restrictions because
right.
she can't have dairy. So,
oh, wow.
you know, and it's a vegan, vegetarian. You
oh,
know,
that's a tough one.
Yeah, I did it, but, and she loved it, absolutely loved it. So.
Yeah. And I just think it's so funny. In the documentary, you said that, you know, you're telling her that she's a little unhappy with the visitors.
Yeah.
That are coming to visit because they're not men.
We had two guys on the filming crew, and she has a thing for accents, and they both had British accents.
Oh.
And if she knew they were on the grounds where she lives, she wanted them. And if,
wow.
you know, it wasn't always the right moments because we're trying to do breakfast yeah. or lunch or cleaning, and she's like, I want the boys. Don't give me these other visitors. I want the boys. She doesn't really mince words. She lets you know what she's
wow.
what she's looking for.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
So funny.
Yeah.
And, I mean, we have very touching moments, too, that that you told us about. And it makes me cry, but I'll try to just go mm-hmm. through it quickly. But when Michael passed away, the male gorilla mm-hmm. that she first was... paired up with, originally you were hoping that Michael and she would, you know, have little baby gorillas.
Yeah.
But that didn't happen because they were little kids together.
Yeah, she thought of him as a brother.
Right, right.
Right.
Yeah.
So, and in gorilla families, that's taboo, mm-hmm. you know.
Right.
If you even consider him your brother, you don't do that, just like us.
Right, right.
So.
That's a no-no.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm kind of frowned upon.
Yeah, so when he passed away, it was like losing her brother.
Oh, yeah,
and
exactly.
you can tell it's still something yeah. that, you know, she thinks yeah. about and uh-huh. grieves over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you literally said that she was hiding in the room. She didn't want to come out after Michael passed away.
Yeah.
So you guys brought Robin, right?
Yeah, Robin Williams came for a visit.
Yeah.
And I wasn't working here at that time,
yeah,
but I've heard the stories
yeah.
and that, you know, that visit,
yeah.
he, you know, she really liked his movies.
Yeah,
Awakenings
right.
was one of her favorite movies at the time.
Yeah.
And him, I think, I want to say Mrs. Doubtfire was one she enjoyed.
Oh, yeah.
But when he came to visit, it just lifted her spirits. And for the first time in so long, she laughed. And
yeah.
it was a really beautiful
yeah.
exchange yeah. between the two of them.
Right, right. Well, I got to see the movie on Channel 9, KQED, and it was so interesting and amazing because Robin was like laughing and I mean, Coco was cracking Robin up,
right?
Which is kind of ironic. You
yeah.
know?
Well, she cracks us all up. She's really yeah. funny. Yeah.
And so, was Coco tickling him first, or was Robin tickling Koko.
She starts the tickle game. It's one of her favorite games. She instructed him to tickle.
Oh.
And then she tickles back. She likes to do tickle and chase. So they were doing a little combo. Yeah. And then she took his glasses and checked his ID.
Wanted to make sure it was Robin Williams.
Yeah. Then she went and found a DVD, though, with his picture on it to show that she recognized knew who he was.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That is really deep.
She's really good at doing matching.
Yeah.
That's something she does a lot.
Oh, my gosh. That's incredible. Yeah. Really amazing.
She is, yeah.
And then the other story that you told me that I thought was so endearing, tell us about the caregiver that was like years ago, right?
Yes. Well, in the filming of the documentary, you'll see a clip. Well, she's interviewed, and it's Anne Southcombe, and she was Michael's caregiver in the early days.
Okay.
And she came back for the filming of the documentary, and they interviewed her, and then we had her come visit Koko.
Oh.
And I'd never seen anything like it. I escorted her up to see Koko, and Koko recognized her immediately, wanted her to come over, wanted to hold hands with her, wanted to kiss her, wanted to play chase.
Yeah.
You could just see this longing and this, you know, and just couldn't quite get enough of her, like wanted to embrace, you know, just kissing her through the mesh. I mean, it was just precious. And then when it was time for her to leave, Koko made sounds I had never heard.
Oh, wow.
And it was like this crying sound, like, and her little belly was shaking, and I stepped in. I said, Koko, it's not going to be another 25 years before you see her again. I'll make sure she comes back again.
Oh,
and then
good.
It was fine, and she could go. And
good.
Yeah, it really stuck with me, and I couldn't even tell the story without crying for like a week. I mean, it really had a profound impact on me seeing the depth of their emotions.
Right, right.
Yeah.
I mean, we animal lovers know how intense and how, you know, intelligent they really are, but I think it's important, you know, to teach people that, you know, we really don't know how amazing, you know, they really are until you see stuff like this.
We kind of think we have a corner on the market.
Yeah.
And we're primates too.
Exactly.
And it's so shocking to us that others could be just as gifted.
Yeah.
They are.
They are.
It's pretty true. Obvious when you work with them every day.
It's very true.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's so true.
Yeah, it is.
And I think her smorgasbord of food is amazing. I mean, my gosh, that nice big plate of lettuce and does she get to eat?
Well, that's actually an interesting story.
Oh, yeah.
Because we make her a big platter of greens every day, and we call it her browse because she gets to browse through it and see what she wants to eat.
Yeah.
And there isn't a sign for browse, so she created her own. She made an S at her brow, which is brows.
Yeah.
So now we know when she says this, it's what she wants, it's her brows.
Cool.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Okay, and then, so let's talk about the sign language itself, because there's hundreds probably.
Oh,
she's
pretty fluent. I mean, I'd say about 3,000 words.
Whoa.
She has her staple words that she uses because they come up a lot in a day.
Yeah.
But it's really neat that she will sign to the level the person she's talking to is at.
Wow.
So I'm not a fluent sign language person.
Yeah.
So she'll talk to me with words she knows I know. And then she'll up her game when she thinks you've been around long enough, you should know these. So she'll start using them more frequently. And then I'll see her shift to somebody else who might not know as many as I do.
Yeah.
And she'll kind of dumb it down for you. And then we have a few caregivers that are very fluent, and her sign language increases with them.
Really?
So she can really adapt.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Oh my God. So cool.
Yeah.
And you also told me a really neat story about how during the holidays, Koko likes to wear leis.
She does.
Like a Hawaiian lei.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
She does. She likes, they're necklaces, but we do them for each festive holiday, plus yeah. their flowers, which I yeah. told you she does like her flowers. But yes, she likes, we fancy a lot of things up. She enjoys pretty cups. She yeah. enjoys the way you decorate her plate. Wow. Presentation's really big with her. And actually uh-huh. with Ndume as well. He really likes presentation.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Very good. Well, yeah. And what was the, where she did the very deep sign language series where she was saying, man is stupid.
Oh, that was the voice of nature for the summit in France for okay. drawing a blank CO
something.
Yes, but you can see it on YouTube. It's and you oh, can yeah. see it all over the web. It's.
I cried when I watched it.
It is beautiful.
But it's powerful. It's mm-hmm. really impacting. I mean, what were some of the words that she signed?
She signed that man is stupid, yeah. and that we need to protect the planet.
Right, right.
And yeah,
things like that. But yeah. very powerful words.
Yes.
Yeah, and my gosh, it has a really strong message. Very good message. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
yeah.
But and tell me a little more about Ndume. So.
Yeah, well, Ndume was also hand-reared and uh-huh. was raised in a zoo in yeah. captivity, but he didn't have as much hands-on as Koko. Oh, so if yeah. you, Koko was raised more in a human environment, and uh-huh. he was raised more as a gorilla in a uh-huh. zoo setting.
Oh.
So it's they're very different,
yeah.
but also the same. I mean, they're both very sweet.
Okay, that's great. Oh, that's so amazing. Actually, can you tell us what the email address is?
You mean our website?
Yeah.
It is www.koko.org, which is koko.org.
All righty, good. Yeah. I forgot to ask you that earlier, sorry.
That's okay.
But that's wonderful. And like you said, they're in YouTube also.
Yeah.
They can see a lot of those.
You can see a lot of our videos and yeah. follow us on Facebook. We've got great photos every day.
That's great.
Yeah.
And Flea was there.
Yes.
And he showed his guitar
yeah.
to Koko.
His dream was to play bass for her, and the dream came true, and she loved it.
Right.
And, oh, he is a wonderful guy, and oh, cool. she just adored him.
Great. Lisa, I want to thank you so very much for joining us.
Yes.
And come back, okay?
I will, for
thank
sure.
You.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. And thank you so very much for joining us. Until next time, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move. Have a great day. So I want to talk a little bit more about
if you see us in your business, you'll see us on TV. World a better place. We're on the move. We're striking out to set the pace. We all can choose to make a difference. Our time is overdue. If we collect our dreams, take them on the move. If we collect our dreams, take them on the move. So let's pick up our dreams, take them on the move.